Of two very, very talented men. A week from today, they're going to be inducted into the Theater Hall of Fame. And then they'll probably get so uppity that we'll never see them again. So, for what may be the last time, composer John Kander and lyricist Fred Ebb. Razzle dazzle them. Stars of tonight's performance. First, from the original Broadway cast of The Rink, Scott Ellis, Mel Johnson Jr., Jason Alexander, Scott Holmes, Frank Mastrocola, Ron Carroll, and ladies and gentlemen, Sharon Daniels, Stanley Wexler, Salento, Sandy Stewart, Chris Durang, and Dawn. Werner Klemperer, Stockard Channing,
It's good to see you after all these years. You've really lifted my morale.
We love you guys.
Kept it all together after all these years. What's your secret? I can see that fortune has been kind to you. Guess you've had no obstacles to climb.
John looks good. Fred looks fine.
These were taken in 79.
What's your secret? What's your key?
Hey, what about writing a show for me?
They wrote 10 shows and that's not all.
They lived through one with Betty Bacall.
What a career, couldn't be grander. Give a cheer for Evan Kander. I can see that fortune has been kind to you. You've had no obstacles to climb. Gee, you look terrific after all these years. Completely unchanged by
fortunate to be in the Broadway revival of one of the most popular Kander and Ebb shows, Cabaret. Now, there have been a lot of big hits in John's and Fred's career. Their first hit song was in 1962. They had just started collaborating and they were working on material for Kay Ballard, who at the time was a regular on the Perry Como show. One day, they brought her a song called My Coloring Book, and she loved it. But she thought it would be perfect for Sandy Stewart, another regular on the Perry Como show. So, during that week, Sandy Stewart sang it on the air with a result of over 20,000 letters. The song was so popular, she recorded it, and she was nominated for a Grammy as Best Female Vocalist. Now, what is remarkable is that 30 years later, Kay is still talking to Sandy. Ladies and gentlemen, now here tonight to sing Kander and Ebb's first hit song and accompanied by her son, Bill Sharlop, the original recording artist, Sandy Stewart.
Enchanté. For those who fancy coloring books, and lots of people do, here's a new one for you. A most unusual coloring book, the kind you never see. Crayons ready, very well, begin to color me. Thank you. until she came between.
Bye. like to sing a song now that Freddie and John wrote for Barbara Streisand. For a movie called Funny Lady. And let me tell you a little bit about it. It's the further adventures of Fanny Bryce. And in this one particular scene, her one and only love, Mickey Arnstein, comes to her and he tells her that he has married someone else. But I kind of think that the ladies in our business can relate to that quite easily. Because there's a big difference between professional success and personal failure. Well, picture, if you will. The 1930s. A very successful lady who has everything. Everything but the man that she loves. But odi, 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 ain't I got fun? But odi, odi, I'm the luckiest one. Satin on my shoulder and a smile on my lips. How lucky can you get? Money in my pocket, right at my fingertips. How lucky can you get? How lucky can you get? When I see the chauffeur, think I'll give him a raise. How lucky can you get? Weekends in the country with the Baron, of course. And a wardrobe to choke Mrs. Astor's pet horse. My circle of friends. Someone I am crazy for is crazy for me. I'm his personal pet. Gee, how lucky can you get?
There's a lady living somewhere. Where it is, I do not know. But I long to write and tell her that I love her so. I believe I might do mayhem. Yes, I might destroy myself if I ever found her missing from my grocer shelf. To Sara Lee, Sara Lee. There's no H, just Sara Lee. And that's okay by me, 'cause I'm living in paradise when I'm nibbling apple spice from the kitchens of the one I Sara Lee.
Sara Lee.
And it thrills me right to my soul.
Sara Lee.
When I'm chewing her finger roll.
There's no one.
You'll hear me saying,
like,
for goodness sake, there'll never
Lee.
Be a better banana cake. 'Cause Milton works at the Hilton. He caters banquets. Affair, he'll swear by Sara Lee.
I really know what you mean. Aren't her brownies obscene?
Drop that H, say Sara.
Sara
Lee, and that's okay by me. I love your cheesecake white as pearl. And did I mention that chocolate swirl from the kitchens of the one I
before us he stands. I say, look, what a happy face. You say, look, he's got dirty hands. We see a child in a maple tree. We're watching him climb, you and I. You say, come down, you'll hurt yourself. I say, go up, you're touching the sky. There's a difference between us. No observer could miss. Between us, only this. Seeing things, there's a way of seeing things, a certain way of seeing things that makes the difference. Is that sun up there? Spun of light and air, or just an everyday practical sun. You and I have a way of seeing things, a different way of seeing things. I'd say, paint your truth with mine. consider seeing things my way.
Attractive and charming forever it seems, disturbing, disarming, my spinner of dreams, a different dream.
John Kander and Fred Ebb are two deeply philosophical human beings. Musicologists have devoted whole chapters to the way in which Kander and Ebb use their art to plumb the depths of the greatest existential questions of our time. I think we should just consider a few of their song titles. There's a little bit of good in everyone. Everybody's for sale. Say yes. So what? And of course, New York, New York. All right. And yet, though these guys may wrestle with the vagaries of human nature and human vagaries, they are basically optimists at heart. After all, these are the two that told us once, life is a cabaret. Of course, they also told us that life is what you do while you're waiting to die. But hey, why quibble? Now, one of their more philosophical songs will be performed in a new show opening next month. It's a review based on Kander and Ebb songs, and we are very fortunate to have the cast here tonight to perform one of them for you. So we take this moment to be just a little thoughtful, a little profound, and more than a little deep.
Hit it, guys!
The trouble with the world today, it seems to me, is
coffee in a cardboard cup. The trouble with the affluent society is coffee in a cardboard cup.
No one's ever casual or nonchalant.
No one wastes a minute in a restaurant.
No one wants a waitress passing pleasantries like,
"Hiya, miss. Hiya, sir. May I take your order, please?"
I'd like a coffee,
coffee.
Coffee. Sugar.
No decaf, no sandwich.
Here we go. The trouble with the world today is plain to see is everything is hurry up.
It's a rush it through.
Don't be slow.
Get the BLT.
On her eye to go and coffee.
I think she said coffee.
I know she said coffee.
In a cardboard cup.
The trouble with the helter-skelter life we lead is coffee in a cardboard. The trouble psychologists have all agreed is coffee in a board.
Wah, 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 wah.
Tell me what could possibly be drearier
than seaboard from the Bill Nord cafeteria.
Seems to me a gentleman would much prefer an
afternoon. How you been? May I take your order, sir?
The trouble with the world today is plain to see is everything is hurry up.
It's ready whip.
Instant tea.
Minute right.
And mile me there.
Coffee.
I think she said coffee.
I know she said coffee.
I'm sure she said coffee.
In a cardboard cup.
The trouble with the
world today. Oh, nobody knows.
It's nobody
not in
knows.
A cardboard. The trouble I've seen.
What?
The trouble.
Oh,
the way
no,
we like
no,
to take.
Nobody knows.
Nobody
knows if you see what I mean.
No one knows the meaning of utopia. Is that we can't think we got trouble?
Oh,
that
is killing me,
that's nervous.
Oh.
But go there, be right back. Won't you care for separate checks?
The trouble with the world today is plain to see. Is everything is hurry up. It's all become gloomy shoes, the sugar packs, and plastic spoons, and coffee.
I think they said
coffee.
I'm sure they said
coffee.
I know they said
coffee.
They must have said
coffee.
I hope they said coffee.
Yeah,
they said coffee.
In a cardboard.
Hot. Red steamy.
Strong.
Sweet.
Yum.
Oh, I gotta pee.
Maybe this time he'll stay. Maybe this time, for the first time, love won't hurry away. He'll hold me fast.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kander and Ebb like nothing more than to have two women walk to the front of the stage, sit down, stare at the audience, and share their deepest, innermost thoughts.
Where you pray and grieve. hours were spent by the sea.
So what?
And we had a maid doing all of the housework, not we.
So what? Now we scrub up the floors and we wash down the walls and we empty the chamber pot. If it ended that way, then it ended that way. And we shrug and we say, so what? Life is what you do while you're waiting to die. This is how the time goes by.
Thank you. Hello, I'm Chris Durang, and this is Dawn, and together we're Chris Durang and Dawn. We hoped that you enjoyed that challenging medley. Dawn and I prefer medleys because we have short attention spans. I used to be a playwright, but it was too hard. So a couple of years ago, I decided to become a lounge singer. And so I hooked up with John Augustine and Sherry Anderson and Michael O'Flaherty and Brad Flickinger, and we have been traveling around the country performing at Ramada Inns and convention centers everywhere. It's been horrible. The younger audiences want us to sing Michael Jackson, Paula Abdul, Guns N' Roses, but we give them Kander and Ebb and we make them like it. You know, when you do a cabaret act, you often hope that someone will write specialty material, especially for you, and we have been very fortunate in that John Kander and Fred Ebb wrote a song especially for us. It arrived in the mail one day anonymously, and although we didn't really quite understand why John and Fred wrote what they did for us, still no sense looking a gift horse in the mouth. It's Liza with a Z, not Lisa with an S, cause Lisa with an S goes not Z. It's Z instead of S, line instead of V. It's simple as can be, C, Liza. Now you try it with me. It's Liza with a Z, not Lisa with an S, cause Lisa with an S goes not Z.
Z instead of S,
line instead of Lee. It's simple as can be, see Liza. Now if my name were Ada, I'd be Ada. Even backwards, I'd be Ada. Or if my name were Ruth, I would be Ruth. Because with Ruth, what can you do? Or Sally, or Margaret, or Ginger, or Faye. But when you're a Liza, you always have to say, it's Liza with a Z, not Lisa with an S. Cause Lisa with an S goes not Z. It's Z instead of S, I instead of Lee. It's simple as can be, see Liza. Liza Minnelli. It's Italian, blame it on Papa, what can I do?
You know, people ask me, speaking of names, how Dawn came to be called Dawn and whether we took it from Tony Orlando and Dawn. Well, in truth, I had heard of Tony Orlando and Dawn, but then I just forgot. But... When we remembered, we decided to stick with the name Dawn, but we spell it with an E at the end of it so that Tony Orlando doesn't want to sue us. It's
Dawn spelled with an E, not Dawn without an E, cause Dawn without an E goes Dawn, not Dawn. It's D-A-W and then E. It's Chris Durang and Dawn, it's easy.
Liza Minnelli, it's Italian. Blame it on Papa, what can I do? Every Sandra, who's a Sandra?
Every Mary, who's really Marie?
Now every Joan, who is a Joanne?
Has got to agree with me when I've announced I don't mind being pummeled or trampled or trounced, but it does drive you bats to be mispronounced.
You try it with us. It's Liza with a Z, not Lisa with an S, cause Lisa with an S goes nuts up. Z is at best, Liza to be, it's who knows, maybe see Liza. Then M I double N, then E double L, you double N, that's not new. Then E double L, and with an I, that's what you say. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm very excited to say something I never thought I'd say. Here is the real Liza with a Z.
Looky, looky, the lucky lady came in. Saints preserve us from the tiffany at the hootie to begin. Looky, looky, the lucky lady came in. Diamonds on her bow, emeralds on her stern. She tacked in and dropped her anchor, land of Goshen, come up anchor. A holy cow, and wow, Jehoshaphat, I get to see where you've been. Let's have a bash, pour out the cash. Looky, looky, lucky lady came in. Oh, boy, look at the line of her catch. The splendid sign of her vest up. Doesn't she weaken your knees? See the hull and the keel of her. Don't you long for the feel of her when she's purring along in the breeze? What a crack! Her fore, her aft could make your compass spin. So now that she's here, nestling in her berth, shored up, getting the money's worth. I hope for navigation, let's throw a celebration to show appreciation. The lucky lady.
First for me. I've never, ever been on a stage, especially at, well, I don't think I really ever have been on a stage and said something that Fred Ebb has not written. Fred and John were so nervous tonight that I asked him what I should say, and he just kind of said, whatever you think, and left me alone. I thought about it, and I realized that what he always said to me was, shut up and sing. All the songs that Fred and John have written for me, which is a wonderful thing to be able to say, most of them have been almost kind of personal anthems and stuff I believe in. And luckily, stuff most people believe in.
Sometimes you're happy and sometimes you're sad. But the world goes round, and sometimes you lose every nickel you've had. But the world goes round. Sometimes your dreams get broken in pieces, but that doesn't alter a thing. Thank you.
But not hives. Anyway, the first song that I sang was from a movie called Lucky Lady, and Fred and John wrote the title song. The World Goes Round, which is also going to open, Fred and John's show, and The World Goes Round opens on March the 18th. So you all have to go see that. But that song was written for New York, New York. And now I have a premiere. I just finished a movie called Stepping Out. And luckily for me, Kander and Ebb wrote the title song, and I'd very much like to introduce it tonight. Hey!
Oh, well, I'll go it alone.
time I heard the music for the show that I did with Hal Prince by Kander and Ebb, called Floor of the Red Menace, I thought I was going to die. It was so wonderful, I thought I was just going to stop. And then I think when people ask me what I'm proudest of in my whole life, I think I'm proudest of the songs that have been written for me. I really am. And this song, as opposed to what some of you might think, was also written for me. I mean, about our city. I know the man with blue eyes keeps singing it, but it was, in fact, written especially for me. Right? Truly. But I'm going to get killed, but that's all right. What a wonderful way to go. I'm now going to get killed, but I want to introduce, I think, the finest musician and performer and the finest performer I ever met. The finest performer I ever saw, and I saw some good ones. Ladies and gentlemen, the man who all the people you've seen tonight love and respect, and the other man who we care about with all of our hearts. I can't say more, we just love them. Ladies and gentlemen, Kander and Ebb.
Fred writes the lyrics, so I'm going to talk. When something like this happens to you, it leaves you kind of speechless and bewildered and weird. It's a wonderful event. Almost everybody connected with this performance tonight, on stage and off, is someone with whom we've worked often and closely. And they are our family. So if tonight you're here to honor us and our talents, you are most definitely here to honor theirs.
John writes the music, so I'll talk. Some years ago, a man with a taste for an aphorism, I guess, came up with an expression, which is, be careful what you wish for, you just might get it. And when I was a kid, I wished for all this. I wished to be a songwriter people had heard of. I wished for a collaborator who would also be my very good friend. I wished I would know talented, loving, beautiful people, and maybe one night they would sing for me. And all of those wishes have come true. So to the man with the aphorism, I say, I'm eloquent sometimes. I would just like to say, if there are any young songwriters out there, don't believe in that. Don't be careful what you wish for. Wish for it all. Because just like me, you might get lucky and it just might happen. So, Liza, would you sing New York, New York?
No.
No.
I want Freddie to sing it. Nobody in the world sings it like Freddie. Johnny, when you play it, this is the way I first heard it. And I promise I won't interrupt, I won't say a word. I know I'm always too noisy, but I won't do it this time, okay? Okay. All right? I'll even go on.
Sing it.
today. In a city.